This video will teach you how to make axisymmetric mesh in Gmsh, which is for use in Openfoam. Now the geometry of the mesh that we are going to build is like this. And based on this nomenclature presented here, we are going to make an axisymmetric mesh in Gmsh. First, make a new folder where you want to save the files in the project. Then make a file with the extension GEO. Now open the Gmsh and a text editor where you will be editing the mesh file side by side with the Gmsh so that you can view both the GUI and the code part at the same time. Okay, I have set it up like this. So this is where you will write your code and generate your mesh on the right side. First, we need to define the inputs to our mesh. So based on these input parameters, we should be able to change our mesh as we want, like increasing the size, decreasing the size, changing the number of shells, that sort of things. So let's define the input. After defining the inputs, we'll create points. So these points would depend on the inputs that we have defined earlier. And the way you define the points is that you give the coordinates of the point in first three inputs, three arguments. And then the last argument would be the size of the cell that you want at that point. Now, so to define the size, you might need to add another variable which dictates what the size of the cell should be. Now, depending on your inputs and other inputs for number of cells that you want along an edge, you can change the cell size at different points. So you can define the number of cells or the cell size before you make the points. After doing that, we will keep on adding other points that are needed for the mesh. After adding the points, now we can join the points to make a line. So while making line, I am joining points in positive direction so that the leftmost point is given first and the second point is given as a second argument. So that the line that's made, which is sort of a vector and has a direction, would always point in a positive direction. So that's just a convention that I'm following. Now you can save this code and load that in the Gmsh so that you can visualize what are the points that we have made just now and the lines that we have made. It's easier to work this way. You can see the lines you made on the code as we go along. Now let's add other lines as well. After making all the lines, we can see that we have two different blocks. Another line joining 0.37 and 0.48 is missing, so let's add that line as well. Now the blocks are complete. Now we have four blocks. After making a line, before making a mesh, you need to make a closed loop out of those lines. So we will make four closed loops. And while making the loops, you have to take into account the direction of the line that we have defined in the previous line section. So it should be continuous. You can change the visualization in Gmsh so that it's easier to make closed loops. The negative signs before the name of the lines change the direction of the line so that, yeah, it's a perfectly continuous loop. Now let's load again the file that we have created here, the code, to see if there's any error. It seems like it's working fine. Now after making this closed loop, we are ready to create the surfaces from these loops. Now we have made the surfaces, and let's again load that into Gmsh and visualize the surfaces. Yeah, we can see that there are surfaces here. These dotted lines represent the surfaces. Now since we have already made a mesh, and we have already defined the size that needs to be at these points, we can make a mesh right now without changing anything. So to do that, make a 1D discretization first and then 2D. And you can see that we already have an unstructured mesh right there. This might already be good enough for someone who wants this sort of mesh. But if you want to use this in OpenFoam, this is not done yet. You need to make a 3D mesh. So we are going to change this, make a 3D mesh, and make it sort of structured. Now another thing to point out in this mesh is that this triangular mesh, which has only single node at the axis of symmetry, would be a problem in OpenFoam, so we need to get rid of that. These cells have just one node at the axis of symmetry. An open form needs at least two nodes on the axis of symmetry to make a cell. So it would throw an error on this mesh if you want to use this in open form. If the simulation is not axisymmetric, then the mesh should be fine. So to get rid of those ill-conditioned cells, what we can do is we can define some basic algorithms of making this mesh. So we would define those options right before we do anything. So at the start of the code, we would define the options that we want. So we change the algorithms to make the mesh. So you can do that manually in the GUI interface as well. You need to go to mesh and general. And these are the settings that we are changing with the code here on the left. Mesh smoothing and recombine all. This would recombine these triangular meshes to make it more quadrilateral shaped where it's possible. So that should do the trick. That should remove the cells that had only one node at the axis of symmetry. Now, since we need a three-dimensional mesh in open form, the mesh we have created right now is just two-dimensional. We need to rotate it in x-axis and extrude it so that it's a 3D proper 3D mesh. So we will do that right now. Before doing that, after recombining and adding these new algorithms, new settings for the algorithms, we can see that the mesh we have generated is pretty structured and that ill-conditioned cells are already gone. Now, to make an axisymmetric mesh along this x-axis, along the line joining point 9 and 6, we will first rotate this mesh in negative 2.5 degrees along x. Let's do that first. So you use rotate to do that, but the units would be in radians, so you should change it from degrees to radians. And the first two parameters there, the first one should define the axis through which you are going to rotate it. And you add the surface that you want to rotate inside the curly brackets. Like this. So after rotating this, we can do an extrude in the angular direction so that it makes a portion of this axisymmetric geometry. So we are going to extrude that in a rotated fashion along the x-axis. And now in the extrude, we are defining the angle we want to extrude to as 5 degrees, because we have already rotated the initial mesh to negative 2.5 degrees. And the total angle of this three-dimensional geometry would be 5 degrees. You can decrease that even more if you like, but that's the angle that I'm using for now. Now, after doing this, we need to define the physical surfaces which will be used to apply different boundary conditions in open form. So let's do that. It's easier to create physical surfaces in the GUI, so I'll be doing that in the GUI interface. Go to Geometry, Physical Groups, Add, and start adding the surfaces you want. So I'll name my first boundary as right and select the surface and press E to end. So that would create a physical surface with name right and the surface that I've selected there. And you can also view the chains in the left. Now let's move on and add all the paths that we need, all the boundaries that we need. In the same manner. Now I'll also add the axis line as one of the physical surfaces as bottom. After doing that, our mesh is ready. Now we can compile this to make a Gmsh out of this .geo file. And these are the commands that you need to do that. And to make an OpenFoam mesh out of this, you need to use Gmsh to OpenFoam command, which is already present in OpenFoam installation. So with this, you should be able to get a three-dimensional mesh that would be used in OpenFoam for axisymmetric simulations. Finally, let's visualize the mesh that we have created just now. And yeah, this is the mesh that we have generated. And it's good to go, ready to be used in OpenFoam simulations. This is all for today. Take care.